It's Joelle here from Strong Mind Soft Heart, and today I am so excited to be giving you a tour of our homeschool room / multifunction space. Joelle, and this channel is Strong Mind Soft Heart. I'm married to David and we have five beautiful children whom we are homeschooling, and this is my youngest child, Michaela. She is 6 months old and she has recently decided to not sleep as much as she was sleeping before. So I'm really praying and hoping that we're going to get back into some sort of habit, but I think possibly she's teething and growing and all of those things that 6 month old babies do. So we're going to be all right. We're going to get through it. Anyway, it's not gonna stop us from doing this video today. I'm so excited. Now, I have never done a homeschool room tour before, and that's simply because I've never really had a homeschool room. And to be honest, I don't really have a dedicated homeschool room, if that makes sense. Now, I definitely store our supplies in this room, and we do use this room for our group reading and that sort of thing. But to be honest, my kids learn wherever they want to learn. Okay, I'm going to start right here because this is my absolute favorite spot as far as homeschooling goes. I love to sit right here on this very loved couch. And this is where we do our devotions and we do our read aloud, excuse me, and like our group activities. So on other videos that I'll be doing in the future, you'll see a little bit more the curriculum that we actually do use and our style of homeschooling. It's a little bit eclectic, but we basically do unit studies. So my kids are learning all together, and then they learn, they do their work in their individual grades. So a lot of our learning is done together, and things like history and geography and Bible and memory verses and all those sorts of things can actually be learnt together at the same time. So I love to sit on this couch and we start by doing our prayer, our memory verse, we read our read aloud. Sometimes for the younger kids, we'll read a storybook. And it's just a really special time. And my kids absolutely love this time. They usually sit on the carpet down here with some Lego or blocks or a drawing book or coloring in, and we take about an hour, and it's a really wonderful time of the day where we can stop and they are listening to their mummy teach them and they are learning, and it's a really lovely time of day. So I love this couch. And also my kids use this couch to sit and do their own reading or their own imagining, being creative and all those wonderful things that kids do. So I love this couch. I'm gonna start with these shelves right here. So as you can see, this top shelf here is just full of really precious memories. A lot of these memorabilia we've actually gotten on our trips overseas or in our traveling together. So it's special for the kids and for me. So that's up there. Oh, baby girl. And yes, that's very important. That's a very cute little picture of Isaac when he was a baby. Okay, so in this drawer here, oh my goodness, this is a lot of workbooks and curriculum that I am either saving for as the kids get older. Some of the things Joseph is finished with, but I can reuse them for his younger siblings. Some of the things are like this geography book. I'm not using that right now, but because I don't need to yet, but in the future I will. So that's sitting there. So things that I will be using, but not using exactly right now. We've also got our computer right here. So that gets pulled out. Underneath here, I've also got, so these boxes are mine. So I've got folders there with work samples. I've got headphones for the computer, little flashcards for preschool age work. I've got some math manipulatives in there, that sort of thing. Alrighty, coming across, this is my little shelf, okay? And I love this little shelf. Nothing to do with homeschooling, but it's just my little spot in the house. So Danny, you're gonna laugh because I am still reading this book. It has taken me forever, but I'm enjoying it and I am gonna get it done. So still reading this book. I've also got my diary, which I use to plan out my day, my slow cooker recipe book. I do use other recipe books, but this is my go-to and I just love it. And I've made it a real a goal of mine to do a lot more slow cooking this year. So I've always got that handy so I can be looking up new recipes. And of course my Bible, so important. And that's a really old picture of Dave and me when I was a teenager and we were boyfriend and girlfriend. Okay, moving along. Now, these may not be in the best order, but what do I have in here? Okay, I've just got some basic. This is for Joseph, my oldest. This is his colouring in and his just his own independent drawing, that sort of thing. In this box here, I've got, sorry guys, this is not the best view. It's very heavy. All the other colouring in books. So Isaac, Darius and Lily all share that box there just for their colouring in. So not so much their homeschool curriculum, but just their fun colouring in, which they do, as I said, when we're doing group time. Also when we go to church, they like to pack their colouring in. So during the sermon, they can colour in. Okay, moving on. I've showed you this one. Moving on to our art box. Now, guys, I'm going to have to do a separate video on this, but like, I'm just not passionate about art. I'm really not. But my kids love it. So I have to make an effort. Our beautiful neighbors actually bought us some beautiful pastels. So I'm not going to take everything out, but I've got paint in here. I've got ribbon. I've got card and cardboard. We've also got their sketchbooks and just some, you know, basic art supplies. I'll talk more about art in another video. Okay, now, moving on. I'm going to come down here for a minute. Hello, Miss May. What are you doing? Oh, you've had enough down there, haven't you? Can you hold on for one more minute? No? Okay. 1 minute. Because I'm also holding Michaela. So on this shelf, we've just got puzzles. My kids absolutely love puzzles. Coming across here, we've got more puzzles and a couple of board games. Okay. Coming across here, we've got some more board games. We're just getting to that age now where we can start to play board games. So obviously, Joseph's almost 10. He's fine, he loves them. But my younger kids, they're just starting to really get it and enjoy it. So hoping to get a bit more into that and to buy some more board games. I also have some Uno and that sort of thing in some other boxes, which I'll show you soon. But that's sort of the start of our collection. Okay, actually, can't even remember what's down here, so give me a second. Miss May, what do we got down here? Oh yeah, so we've just got, you know, the kinetic sand and Play-Doh, that sort of thing. So this is a very multifunctional space, as I said. So those last three cubes down there, that straw sort of one, and then the two pink ones, they have Lily's dresses and skirts. And then all of these gray ones you see, so the three rows here are for my three boys, and the pink row down there is for Lily. So this space has all their clothing as well. And in the future, I will be doing a video on how we keep our kids' clothing organized in our laundry system and all of that. So that's ahead. Now, this is the workbooks, the curriculum that I keep on hand because I need it easily accessible. This is the stuff that we are using right now. So I've got some Matthew C curriculum here. I've got some Gather Round workbooks that we're working on. I've got Teach Your Child to Read in 100 Easy Lessons. So I'm using that for Darius and for Isaac. And I'm about to start Lily on this as well. It's fantastic. Highly recommend that book. I've got pencil cases up here. So my three boys and Miss Lily as well. And then this basket here is so special because David actually made this when he was in high school in woodwork. So now we use it and I have all of the things that we do in our group time. So we've got our Bible, a devotional, we've got our read aloud that we're doing together as a family. I've got the story of the world history and the activity book that goes behind that. So basically anything that we're going to be doing on that couch over there together is in that basket. And sometimes we'll add to it, like for the younger kids, we might put a story book in there as well, you know, like a picture book or something like that. So that's what's over there. Then obviously we've got our globe. This globe is very special. When we first made the decision to homeschool, and I passed our initial registration, David went out and bought this globe, sort of just to represent, yes, we're homeschoolers. We have a globe, we're homeschoolers, woo. If you have a globe, comment down below. I've got another puzzle up there just because we didn't have room for it down below. Some easier puzzles, you know, that's more for Lily and eventually Michaela. Some photos again. All right, moving on. Got our little alphabet banner there. Some babushka dolls. Okay, this is more of our Polish sort of heritage style. That's some artwork that the kids have done. Now, this is not our only bookshelf, but it is the bookshelf that I like to have out here because it's got some very precious books that I don't want getting ruined. And it's got some book collections, that sort of thing. and some future read alouds, and also books that I just would like the kids to be able to pick up and read. We've got some Where's Wally books down here. Dari's got those for Christmas. We've just got some blocks, that sort of thing. Some real classics as well. Some I haven't read some of these yet, but I'm excited to in the future. As I said, we have more books. So my four older kids, two of them share a room each. So two rooms, four kids in two rooms. So we have two more bookshelves, and they sort of rotate their books in between their rooms as well. So we do have lots more books, but these are the ones that I like to keep out here. I've also got some more educational ones. I'm going to be doing a book review pretty soon on this book, Good Pictures, Bad Pictures. I've got it for older kids, and I've also got it for the younger kids, Good Pictures, Bad Pictures. So, whoops, I've got a few things like that. Okay, in that corner stashed away there, we've got a giant box of Lego. In that red box, we have more Lego. We are Lego fanatics in this family. Okay, over here we have Isaac's guitar, because he is learning guitar. And if any other children want to learn guitar, that's available. We've also got our piano. I love the piano. I play the piano. And I'm so excited because, okay, I can't launch into this or this video will just go forever. But again, the whole just letting your kids learn because they want to learn. So I'm so excited. My youngest son, Darius, so my third child, he has just been playing this thing almost every day. Like, I have to ask him to not play it sometimes. And he's never had lessons. I've taught him Mary had a little lamb. I've taught him how to find middle C, and that's about it. But he loves to play the demos that this piano plays. It's a keyboard. So it plays, you know, the classical music, and he listens to it so much. And he's already coming up with his own little melodies. And this is how I taught myself to play piano. And I'm just so excited to see that he is naturally progressing, naturally getting better. He's very musical, and I'm excited to see what the future holds for him. So if he keeps his interest in piano, then obviously we would love to put him in some piano lessons as well. But this is also our music room. So Dave and I, we write original songs. Actually, we have a song coming out next week on this channel, so stay tuned for that. But yeah, so this is also a music space, and that goes with homeschooling as well, obviously. Okay, moving over to this shelf, I've got my Psalm 91 scripture. That's very important. We've got David's degree up there. He's doing his master's at the moment, but that's his Bachelor of Health Science, Health and Physical Education with distinction. Okay, we've got some more Polish, you know, the Polish little eggs and little characters, that sort of thing. Lily loves to play with them, and I'm sure Michaela will soon as well. Okay, in this basket, I've got little activities. So this is more Lily's box, but sometimes the boys will play with the things in here. So, you know, the little stick them in there, fine motor skills, beads. These were my beads when I was little. My mum is so good at taking care of things that I have been able to pass them on. We've got a little magnet set, a little dollhouse set of magnets. I've got Learn to Tie My Shoelaces. This is fantastic. You can just get this from Kmart. So good. So she loves to do those little activities when we're doing our group time. In this box, I think we've got just some wooden trains, that sort of thing. This is little Michaela's box with some baby toys. Okay, over here, as I said, we've got some more board games. We've got Uno, we've got just cards. We've got play money with our pocket money game. That's a great, great game. The kids are learning from that. And then we've just got some other science sort of homeschool activities down there. Here, what do we have here? Oh, lots of little characters, lots of little ushies. Toys, like, I mean, seriously. So many things in here. I don't know if you can see all of that. So many things. And we've got some little play mats and vehicles, that sort of thing. Okay, this is just a box of Jenga. And they're all in each bag. So, started with Joseph. Joseph got a Jenga. Then Isaac wanted a Jenga. And then Darius wanted a Jenga. So we have three Jenga sets in there. Okay, down here. So I told you our kids are really into Lego. So over there, we've got that huge box. And then my boys are always working on something and they don't want their Lego packed away, or they'll get given an individual model, you know, for their birthday or Christmas. So they each have their own Lego box, which is their special thing that they're working on. So each of them have their own little, you know, mat, and then those are their pieces, and they've got their instructions of things that they're building. So I believe that is Darius, I think this is Isaac. You can see a half Lego minion in there, helicopters, that sort of thing. And of course Joseph has, whoops, I'm falling back on the couch, has his Lego things that he's building as well. And Lego is just like the go-to. They love Lego. They could do Lego every single day. Now this is a super important spot. So when we do sit down to do our book work, we sit around this table and I just love it so much. Now this is an 8-seater table. We need to get 2 more chairs. This is also where we have dinner. And as I said, homeschooling for me is not a set time or a set place. Homeschooling is breakfast, lunch and dinner as a family. It's life learning. It's all of that. So this table encompasses so much of our learning. So this is a really special place for us. Okay, and another spot that I need to show you, because it is very important for their learning, is this space. And obviously I am referring to the television. Now look, 100%, there is such thing as too much screen time. And I don't want to have lazy kids, but I cannot tell you how useful the television, movies, documentaries, cartoons have been in my children's learning. Honestly, it has helped them learn so much. And again, oh my goodness, I've got so much inspiration to do about 10 different videos just from this video, because I keep having all of these things that I would love to share with you. But there is a lot that my kids have learned from being able to sit down and enjoy a good movie or a good cartoon, especially if you can get a movie on a subject that you want them to learn about. So I love this room, I love this space, they love it too. There's nothing like a good family movie night. So yes, definitely this space is an important one as well. And even though it's not attached to our homeschool space, they definitely homeschool in here too. Okay, and last but definitely not least is our outside space, which you can't really see right now because it's nighttime. But my kids spend so much time out here riding their bikes, riding their scooters, playing Ninja Warrior, using their imaginations, building forts, playing with rocks, you name it, they're doing it out there. We also live quite close to the bush, so we get wildlife. There's just so much learning that happens out there. And so no, it's not in our homeschool room, but seriously, how could I not add that in? Because it's probably one of the most important spaces that my children learn in. Okay guys, that is it for today's video. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed that. If you have any questions or comments, please put them down below or contact me on Instagram. I would love to chat with you there. Thank you so much for watching today, and I will see you next week on Strong Mind, Soft Heart. God bless you. Bye.